Hey, I'm Pascal from Orange Pixel, and this week I'm uploading daily videos covering a range of topics. Today's topic is how to scope and plan your game project. I have some experience with it. I've been releasing commercial games since 2004. Started with a lot of projects per year. Now I'm at two or three commercially released completed projects. So I know how to finish and also start projects. After the intro, I'm gonna give you some tips and things that help me in scoping my game, the size of the game, but also actually completing that game, usually within a set deadline. So after the intro. Okay, so let's talk about scoping and deciding on how big this project of yours is gonna be and how long you're gonna work on it and how you're gonna maintain and manage all the work that has to be done. The first thing about scope is pretty simple. Set the time or duration that you want to work on your project. It can be like a couple of weeks, it can be 2 months, 4 months, 7 months, a year. Set that time, decide for yourself what's doable. So if you're gonna do this full time, for example, then you want to see the game make money. The more time you put into the game, the more money it needs to make to actually be profitable. If you're just doing it in your free time, spare time, it's probably a lot easier. Decide when you want to be done with this project. I would still recommend setting an end date for yourself. Even if you're just working in the evenings, set a goal for like 6 months from now, I want to have it done. Setting that goal, setting that date is the first thing you should do when scoping your game. Okay, so you have set your deadline, your goal. I'm gonna work on it for 4 months, 5 months, whatever. The next part is planning your workload. And this becomes a lot easier with experience. It's that simple. I'm not gonna give you any magic trick. You need experience to know how long certain parts of the work are gonna take you. Also, it's a lot easier if you have released a lot of games. You can just reuse stuff from older games. There's no shame in that. We all do it. It's actually the best way to create bigger and better games eventually. Reshare or reuse code that you did once before in other games. Just repurpose it for your new game. It might need a little bit of a change, but it's gonna save you a lot of time. So planning comes with experience. It's really a matter of figuring out how long certain tasks take. And obviously you need to have done those tasks before you know how long it takes. So one way to try and avoid a lot of work on a single game is minimize the amount of features that you have no clue on how to create yet. So a quick example for Residual, the game I'm working on now, I wanted the player to swing on vines and have like sort of rope physics type going on. I had no idea how to do it. So I wasted 1 or 2 weeks on this single new feature that I've never done before. I had no idea how long it was gonna take me to create it. In the end, it took me about 2 weeks and then some more days to perfect it here and there. And this is one of the very few features in the game that I've never worked on before. Everything else in the game, even though there's a lot of stuff going on, I've done it before in other games. I can roughly predict how long certain features are gonna take because I did it before. I can copy paste from previous games. I can reuse my knowledge. I can perfect it and improve on it without taking too much time. But the feature like the rope swinging, I never done it before. It took me longer than I couldn't plan for it. I just tried it and I just figured it out and it works. On my next game, I'll know it take me a couple of days because I already did it. I have all the code ready. So the tip here is try to minimize the amount of new stuff you're doing in your game. Don't try to put everything in one game. Just push new ideas and great ideas to the next game. You'll have learned a lot more. You'll be more comfortable with it, more experienced. Just spread it out over a bunch of different games. All right, so let's say we have our scope. We're gonna work on this for 6 months. We have our planning because we have a bunch of experience. We know how long all this is gonna take. How do we actually turn this concept we have into something that's releasable? The first step is pretty easy and most of us have done it, except you in the back, you haven't, but everybody else here has done it. Game jams, they're everywhere. You get a limited time to create a project within a certain concept or a certain keyword or whatever. That's how I also do my prototypes, my private game jams. I'll give myself a week, maybe 2 weeks, and I need to have this idea I have in my head up and running on the computer within those weeks. Not gonna bother with any of the details or any of the other aspects. I just need this this key thing I have, it can be a gameplay idea. What if we have a player who can't jump, but there's a lot of platforms he has to navigate? Work that out. Or it can be just an interesting feeling or an interesting environment I want to create. Whatever it is, 1 week, 2 weeks at tops, I want to have it up and running on my screen, and I want to be able to see if it's actually fun. It can be a lot of fun in my head, but then having it on the computer, it just might not be fun at all. So from this concept, this idea, to the prototype, within a very short time. If it doesn't work, if it's no fun at all, either completely change the idea or scratch it and start something new. All right, so let's say we have our concept up and running, and how do we push this to a releasable game? I think the biggest problem for many developers at this stage is that they're going to be focusing and enjoying what they created in the game jam version and the prototype stage, but they have no idea how to go further, what to do with it. And for them, the fun is over. They had this idea, they wanted to see if it works. It works. End of the fun. For me, the fun begins at that point, because I really enjoy creating a world, something that the player can step into, and there's just a lot to enjoy and a lot to discover and see, and the player can spend as much time as possible. So for me, that's where the fun starts, and I think that's more a mindset for many developers. It's great that you had this idea and it's fun and it works, but if you want to create a full game from it, you need to change your mindset. You need to create a world around this idea and not just the idea. So let's say we're going to create a Pac-Man clone. Everybody knows Pac-Man. We have Pac-Man running around. We have a maze. We have ghosts. The idea is fun. It works. How do we expand this to a full game? First of all, let's just add different mazes. So more content is really the key to create a bigger game. More mazes to be added. Let's create more than just ghosts. Why do we only have ghosts in every level? What if we have other type of creatures that do other type of things? They will stand still at certain points and maybe split up in two. And that's how you really turn a prototype into a commercial game. Just take that core idea and then add twists to it and stretch it, turn it around, increase it and decrease it, and give the player everything they need to enjoy their time in your world that you are creating. You should actually have just a god complex as a game developer. Be the god of this whole new world you're creating for other people. And that brings me to one final thing people ask when talking about scope and everything. How to avoid getting spaghetti code. And if you've never been a game developer and only been using visual tools, because these days there are other ways to create games and you don't really need to code anything. But if you're a programmer, at some point your code is gonna look like spaghetti code. Stuff is gonna be everywhere. It doesn't make sense, but it works. And that's the most important thing. It's also the most important thing to just keep in mind. It has to work, and eventually almost every game code has spaghetti in it. Not everything is going to be clear, and it's fine if code looks messy and doesn't work. And I know in tutorials and school and whatever, wherever you learn how to program, people will tell you to keep your code clean and do the right thing, and it should work like this, and it should. It doesn't. And honestly, the only requirement for code is that it works. Doesn't matter how it looks, doesn't matter how nice it looks and how well it's thought out and designed, and it has to work without bugs. And of course, it's a lot easier if there is some structure to it, but you'll get there with experience. Over time, you'll learn. It's much easier to read if I do it like this. It's much better if I split everything up in tiny pieces, because then if something goes wrong, I can just dive into that tiny piece, or I can reuse that in other areas. You'll get there over time and with experience. But even my game code, after all these years, and I've been programming stuff since like I was 13 maybe, so some decades now, my code is still spaghetti in certain areas. And with every game project I dive in and I create the most beautiful code, and I think this is going to be very clear, but by the time the project is done, it's messy. That's just how game development goes. You'll come up with ideas and you'll fit it in somewhere and the code slips a bit, and then you'll change it a little bit, and then it will be spaghetti code always. I've seen a lot of developers that keep focusing on their code and reiterating and redoing it and changing it and improving it. They never release a game. So seriously, at some point, leave the code for what it is, move on to the next part. It's not gonna get any better. And if it is, you can do that for your next game. Just don't focus too much on that tiny bit of code. If it runs, good enough, move on. All right, that's it for today's video. Lots of topics covered this week. Gonna be another video tomorrow, but I'll be covering my plans for 2021, the Orange Pixel 2021 planning event. I do this every year, set out my goals, and hopefully I'll meet all those goals by the end of next year. Got some great ideas. Residual obviously is gonna be released next year. Very excited about that. Still need to work on it, but yeah, gonna be cool. Also got an idea for my next game, but I have to push that away every day because else I'll just jump in that and stop working on Residual, which is another good thing. Maybe I'll talk a little bit about that tomorrow. Don't know yet. That's it for this week's video though. Or today's video. Oh man, I'm confused. I'm done. It's been a long week. It's been a lot of video creation stuff and work on games. Hope you liked it. Thumbs up, comment below, subscribe. And I'll see you tomorrow as I'm gonna plan out next year. Excited. All right, bye.